Well, hello, guys and gals. It's me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose, back with another edition of Farming Simulator 2015. And today, with the blue skies overhead and the green mountains in the background, it must mean we're back on Court Farms. And the last time we were here, we did a live stream, cut a little chaff, and we began harvesting our canola. And that's where we need to pick up today. We are in field number 4, and we got a little bit of work to do here on the farm because we still have to harvest 4, and I think field number 2 still has canola in it as well. Now, I've disconnected the trailer, as you just noticed, because I need to record a course play course for doing the harvest here and getting all of the canola back over to the farm. And today I want to automate that instead of chasing myself. So what I need to do here is just go ahead and get the tractor set up for that. And I'm going to record a simple course between the two fields that will basically work for both fields. And then that way in the future when I'm doing harvesting, I can just have one tractor set up, do both sides of the fields and all that. I was a little lazy during the live stream and didn't do this. But I'm basically going to just start right here and pick up, and both fields will be able to use this one little course. It will require that I do manual selection on the harvester, but that's fine with me because I normally do that anyways. All right, so we are rolling and we will head on up here to the farm. And I'm doing this without the trailer this time, just to eliminate all those little steps where I gotta stop, disconnect the trailer, reconnect the dupe back up, all that other stuff. It works real, that comes in real handy when the field's way away, but since it's right here at us, I'm just gonna go ahead and record it real quick, come back, hook the trailer up, send the trailer on the route, and then we'll be good to go. If you guys remember from the last episode, also from the live stream, we sold off the Dazur trailer and got the Fortuna just because that big huge tractor or trailer was just too much for the Fendt to handle. The big Fendt, the 900 series, handled it just fine, but the 7 series didn't do as well with it, so we got rid of that. And then we also went and got the tipper for the that works with the IT runner. So that's the two trailers we have now. Now I could have taken the path the short direction and come up through that little pasture area right here behind the potato washer, but because I'm setting this up to be a little realistic, and I wanted the tractor to go over the scales. I came in the direction that we came in, so that's the reason why I'm doing it that direction, which I know in reality that's kind of just a waste because it's automated. We're not going to be watching it happen, so I could have just brought it in however, but again, I'm setting this up for realism, so might as well make it where the path for course play goes over the scales. All right, so bring this back to where it sits right on top of there. Change my direction again. And now we can pull out of here. And again, I want to come way up here because that's where the tractor would actually be setting before I make my turn to come down the ramp. Bring her down, come around. That's good. There sits the other trailer. All right. Head back out. All right, and that'll be it. Now, I don't anticipate using two tractors on this small of a field ever, so the course on it really doesn't matter to me. I can keep it kind of, you know, overlapping. I don't have to worry about making sure they have separation for two tractors not to run into each other. All right. So we'll run this down here, get to the end of the road. That'll be our stopping point for it. And once that is done, then we'll be able to hook the trailer up, send it on its way to go tip the canola that's in it, and we'll get the combine fired up and get to going. So yeah, again, we'll just bring it right here to the end of this. Set it up. I'll stop this. And we'll just call this field four to silo. So we'll save this. And we are good to go on that. So now all we have to do is roll over here, grab our trailer, and we'll hook everything back up. When I plant this field back, I'm going to make the areas around these telephone poles a little bit more oblong instead of being round like they are. I'm not going to take anything out or do any map editing or anything. I'm just going to plow it so that it's just easier to do everything on it. All right. That is there. All right, so let's set this up and do it right. We are doing combine mode, and we're using the route field four. That's already in, because we can see it down here, FO4 to silo. And then we're gonna come over here to combine. Since I'm not sitting in the field, I do need to be on manual. And we're using the Lexicon 550 as always. That's good. Speeds and all that are fine. Let's make sure our speeds are up a little bit. Let's turn our field speed up to about 18. I'm fine with that. The one thing I need to check is make sure my offsets. We did use this for doing the chopping of chaff, so I need to reset my offset back down to automatic just to make sure that I get the right. That it automatically detects the combine and gets the value set off of that and doesn't set it based upon what it was doing when we did the chaff. Start at, say, 60%. I think will work. Yeah, usually I go 65. That's that. So drive course. And it should go do its thing. Hopefully it doesn't go run into a tree. Which it's trying to. Pretty much. It's trying to find the closest path, which is probably right there in the farmyard and not down here at the beginning. So I need to just drive it down here, get it closer to here before I start it. Alright, now if I drive it, it should come right over here. Grab a path and head out. That's still gonna work. Alright, into this thing we go. Let's get it fired up. And we'll get to harvesting some canola. Down to 315 liters of fuel in this thing, so eventually we're gonna have to fuel it up, but we do have that field side container for maintenance, so I can always grab a tractor and bring that over and do that. I'm gonna clean up that little bit of canola there before we head across the road. And we'll get this harvest started. We just start over here in the middle and work our way through this field. But anyways, hope you guys are doing well, and you guys are enjoying the content this week. Thought we'd mix it up a little bit from Manchester and come over and do a little Court Farms for a few episodes. Alrighty. Let's get this done. Alright. Now, as far as the live streams, I think I'm going to try to resume Friday night. And I'm still congested, which means I still have to worry about coughing and all that good stuff. But I'll probably try to resume some live streams on Friday night. And see how that goes. But I'm feeling a bit better. And want to try to get back into the groove. I miss doing them, you know. It's one of those things where, you know, you just kind of like, you're jonesing to do it. But at the same time, you know, you just don't feel like it. But we'll see if we get started back up on Friday. Definitely do the weekend. And knock a couple out. Definitely in a better place than I was a week ago. A week ago I would have said, eh. Alright. Alright, back around here. Reset here and get going again. So yeah, I did, like I said yesterday in the or in the Manchester video, I did a lot of testing with Courseplay over the last week to try and find out exactly what's up with using the auto detect on the combine after somebody brought that to my attention. And I'm going to be curious the next time I do 20 on this farm, I'm going to do auto detect again and I'm going to use it and see what was up with that and see if I have the same issues on 20 that I had before where with auto detect, if I was in one end of the field, the tractor would not come to me until I got back up into the other area of the field. I don't remember now if the tractor was sitting in grass or if it was sitting in the field. I know my path had it in the field, so I just don't know for sure if maybe there was something else going on that I didn't realize. Oops. That's one thing I don't like about this. I need to go ahead and cut the header, I guess. I wasn't going to. But because this thing is right up against that road, the header hits it, so I need to come around, I guess, and cut a little bit of a header on this thing. I thought I could get away without doing it, but note self in the future, don't attempt that. So we'll start a headland here. Get it cut. That way we don't worry of run into... this ground is so unlevel right here. Come on. Wow, really? Right there was a ridge that was just walking this thing wherever it wanted to throw it. So that was messing with me just a little bit right there. But so yeah, we'll try to get some live streams done over the weekend. Need to get back and do some more bus sim. And play it a little bit. I noticed there was a patch today for Ice Lakes, the ice fishing game. I got to look into that and see what that was all about. The developer wrote me a real nice letter today. Let me know that there was already, they've already got some additional content available for that game that they're going to be putting in, implementing in, that is already been developed. It's going to be free for people who already own the game. But from what he was saying, and from listening to him talk, it would appear that in the future there'll be some DLCs for that game as well. So, but apparently they've had a pretty good response off of it so far. He seemed to be real happy. And a lot of you guys seem to enjoy that video, so glad you liked it. Come on, get that pipe out. I'd like to go ahead and unload before I get into these bushes up here. There we go. And I'm going to try to trick this thing a little bit. Just because we are so much on this hedgerow, I'm going to try to trick this tractor a little bit so that I can control it by stopping it right there. And then I'm going to go on around and cut some more. And hopefully by stopping it and holding it, it won't try to make its left turn into the trees or anything stupid. Try and be a little bit more proactive on controlling it and manipulating it so that I don't have any more issue, so I don't have to babysit it as much as far as jumping into it and pulling it out of the hedgerows and such. Alright. I think we get one row on this cut, and that'll give us plenty of room to maneuver and do our thing. Alright, come on around here. And we'll head up. When I'm plowing this field this time too, I want to maybe make a little bit of adjustments to the corners and adjust the size of the field, shape of the field a little bit. So that they're a little more equipment friendly. Alright. What else is going on? Let's see. By the time this goes up, you guys will probably already seen I did an Imperion multiplayer with Dan and Alex the other night. That was fun. I was a little, because I was joining their save game, I was a little hesitant to do some of the stuff. Kind of laid back and just observed, because they're a little more into that than I am. It was more of a learning experience for me, so it was fun. It's nice to get my feet wet on that, so we'll probably be doing a bit more of that in the future as far as videos for the channel. Yeah, it was pretty cool. And then, what else? Got the new Peterbilt up. Got to get back into driving more. How are you guys doing with American Truck Sim? Is it wearing out on you guys right now? Are you about tired of it? Just because it hasn't been updated in so long? Or you guys still enjoying it and having fun with it? I know for me, I'm not really having that much fun with it right now. It just seems like it's lost its luster a little bit because of the fact that it just, there's so little to drive in it. And I think I'm going to do some Euro Truck. in the next few days, because just to do something different and to go down a different path. So let me see if I can get this straightened up here. It is not correct. I want to get it somewhat straight. That sort of looks about right. If we go with that right there. All right. Yeah, I mean, just the fact that it hasn't been updated and that it doesn't look like there's going to be an Arizona DLC until June. It just, I don't know, it's just getting tiresome driving the same routes over and over and over, and it's getting to be a challenge to find a way to make it, keep it fresh, you know. I added in the MHA Pro map, and that's going to give it a different look and feel to it. And then changed up and got the Peterbilt in there. That's going to give it some fun for a little bit. But still looking for ways to make that, you know, enjoyable and not be the same. Go from Elko, Nevada. It seems like I run from Elko, Nevada to the same places every single time. So I think that's probably the reason it's getting a little bit tiresome. But, yeah, I think I might do a little ETS next week. Update the old Pro Mods and jump in there and do a little driving. Just to do something a little bit different. Go back and drive all the European trucks some more. Even though I'm not a big fan of them. Alright. And I think I may try to join Alex and Dan on some Farm Sim on Friday nights again. Alex has got Graceland up and running as far as the map he's running. And is back to doing Farming Fridays. So if he's going to keep doing that, I think I'm going to start joining him on Friday nights. And doing some multiplayer with him on that. So, some of the multiplayer that I do with him, I may not stream anymore. I may just record that stuff and then put it out on a video the next day or something like that, instead of trying to do two live streams in one day or something like that. I think that's going to be my game plan moving forward. Then again, nothing's set in stone. I change my mind a lot of times, like the wind changes. But I don't know, sometimes doing multiple streams is just a challenge. To pull off. There we go. But yeah, I want to get back involved in doing some multiplayer with him. I'm still looking for a good dedicated server to run Farm Sim on, because I think I want to start my own server up with my own farm that you guys can get involved in and be a part of and do. But I haven't found the right host yet that I feel comfortable with. And if anybody knows of a really good US-based host that maybe you've experienced, had a good experience with, let me know, because I'm definitely looking for one that I can utilize. And I don't need TeamSpeak and all that other stuff. I just need a good company whose box is going to run Farm Sim and be stable. Farm Sim is a challenge for some server host. One thing I've noticed is some people have servers and they run a lot better than other people's servers. And I don't know if that's the host company or if that's just the way the server was configured, or the equipment and the map and everything that was on the server. So that's one of my biggest concerns, is I want to find somebody who's got one that's been up and running and it was really stable and they didn't have a whole lot of issues with lag and DDoS and all that other stuff. Before I jump into getting one and making that commitment to spend that kind of money on it. But it's not that much money. It's like, what, $9 a month or $10 a month to do a 10-seat license on one. So it's not really, the money's not the issue. It's just, if I'm going to do it and I'm going to pay somebody for something, I don't want to be beating my head up against the wall every week wondering why it's lagging out really bad for everybody, you know. So if I do set one up, though, I'll get a nice map that everybody enjoys, that'll have some big fields and some a good mix of big and small, and I'll set it up with a few decent mods on there, and keep the mods down to a minimum so that there's not a ton of things that have to be downloaded for it, and then set it up as a multiplayer and public server for you guys to play on, and I'll try and get on there and do some live streams and stuff on it and just have some fun with it and play with you guys a little bit. We'll just make it a ongoing project. When we did the Chellington Farms on Landy server, because it was Landy server, I just really didn't feel like I could get into it as much. I think if I have my own server, my farm, my choice of equipment and everything else like that, my rules, it'll be a little bit easier to do. So I think in thinking about setting that up and getting it going, maybe come up like a list of tasks that needs to be done each day for people to do, and just have some fun with it, but run it like a working farm, and not where all we ever do is silage all the time, or not where all you do is come in and all you ever do is harvest, but you don't ever do any planting or anything else like that. That's the one thing about dedicated servers and setting it up as a public server. Too many people want to get in and all they want to do is harvest. They don't want to do any of the plowing or any of the planting. All they ever want to do is come in and just harvest. The three things that they want to do is silage all the time. They want to go in and cut silage. They want to deforest the map. And harvest. Maybe make bales. I have been on some servers where all they ever want to do is cut grass and make bales. But rarely do you find the guy that wants to get on there and plow. I always crack up about that one. It's like, well, how come you hadn't been on the server in a while? Well, there's never any fields to harvest. Well, that means there's planting and disking and all that needs to be done. Yeah, I just don't do that. Actually, had one guy told me that one time. I was like, how come you never jump on the server anymore? Yeah, every time I ever jump on, there's no fields to harvest. Oh, well. One server we were on messing around with, the guy who ran the server got so tired of coming on, and every time he would come on, all the fields would be harvested but nothing would be planted, so he would delete the harvesters, and that was it. That killed the server, man. After he planted a few fields and deleted the harvesters or locked them out where nobody could get into them, that was it. That was the end of the server. The people stopped coming because they couldn't harvest all the time. It just cracked me up. But we'll set it up. And that's the thing, you'll find I'd rather get a little core group of people together that enjoy doing multiplayer and working as a group. And understand that there's more to do than just harvest the fields. And if we can get a group together that enjoys that and works well together, that'd be cool, you know. And do it on a weekly basis, you know, maybe a couple days a week, get together and do some stuff together. That would be fun. So, but it all starts with finding the right server. So I've been calling around, messing around with some companies. There's one company I want to work with, but I just never can get in touch with them. And it's crazy. They got a telephone number on their website that doesn't work. They've got a Skype number that they never answer. That always goes to voicemail. They have a support email, but if you send them an email and you're not already a client, it kicks you out. They have a response form on their website where you can put in all your pertinent information as far as your name and email address and subject and a brief description of what you're, you know, writing them about. And you can submit that ticket to them, and it comes right back and says, "Yeah, we didn't open a ticket on you because we don't show your email address as listed as one of our customers. So, thanks anyways." And I'm like, "Well, how is anybody supposed to become a customer with you if you don't interact with them?" But they have good servers, and they're in the U.S. They're out of Chicago, I think. And so I really was... They come highly recommended as far as their servers go. But I can't get in touch with them to find out if I can get a FarmSim server set up with them. So it's not on their list of supported games right now, but I know other people who have FarmSim servers on there. So, yeah. It's a matter of just getting with them and going, "Hey, look, I want to get a server and I want to get it set up for FarmSim. What kind of hoops do I have to jump through?" But I can't get anybody to talk to me about it, so it's one of those things. So again, if any of you guys have had first-hand experience with a company in the U.S. that has good servers, that does FarmSim, let me know. Just leave a comment below and I will look into it. But do me a favor and just don't throw out the name of some server company that you know of because you've played something else on one of their servers before. Right? It needs to be where you've had first-hand experience with FarmSim and know that they do a good job with FarmSim, because FarmSim's a different beast than some of the other games that are out there, you know. Because the physics and some of the other things that go on with it. Oh, he's going to run into the tree. Into the tree. Oh, no. He's making the turn. Oh, lucked out. I thought he was going to go into the hedges. Thought for sure he was going to hit the hedges. There he goes. Let's get rid of that. And get that off screen. And spin around here a little bit so we can get a screenshot for our thumbnail. There we go. And let's see what we want to do here. If I can get a little bit further out. There we go. That'll be our thumbnail. I have to remember to do that every once in a while. I don't always remember. And then I'm trying to pull something out of the video afterwards, and I realize, oh, well, you know, the course play placard's in the way or something else is in the way, and nothing really makes good a good thumbnail. Alright, this section's getting kind of small. So I think rather than travel, I think I'm going to start cutting across here. And we'll go ahead and start working around the outside edge of this to finish it up. There we go. Alright, let's do some first person. Since we're not on GPS this time, this one we'll do manual. Because this is going off an odd shape of the field here. Alright. So yeah, the first thing's find a server. The next thing is figure out what map to play. And you guys can make suggestions on that too. What map would be good for setting up a multiplayer server? And I would prefer something that is not English. Or something that is just not all tight spaces and lots of hedgerows and things like that. So, Sandy Bay, nah. Don't see that one happening. And I think maps like that wouldn't be well received on the server anyways, because if I look back at when we were doing Chellington on Landy's server, there's a lot of people didn't like it because of the colliding on the hedgerows. That turned a lot of people off. They don't like that kind of stuff. So, probably wouldn't do that one. Probably wouldn't be good to do. I'll have to look around, see if I can find a good map to do it. Alrighty. Back up a little bit here. Down, and we'll be on GPS for this pass and continue to get this done. So anyhow, so we'll leave your comments below, let me know what you guys think, and we will go from there. If forestry wasn't so bad as far as the lag and everything that it creates, I would love to do a forestry server and just do a whole, you know, do a big forestry operation where somebody's cutting trees, somebody's skidding trees out, there's trees being processed and stuff. But you put too much tree on the ground, then you start having lag issues, and I don't know how well that would work. Have to be the right group of people too. Alrighty. Been checking the mods this week. Hadn't really seen anything that impressive mod-wise coming out in a while, so, you know, though I'll probably start looking at a bunch of maps this week, try and find that right map to do for a a server. And as I do that, I'll probably end up doing some little map reviews or map guide showcases. There's a couple that actually looked interesting. There's one I downloaded the other day. I just haven't taken the time to go through it. I think it was Kingstown or something like that. It actually looked pretty good from the pictures I had seen of it. Then again, sometimes pictures are misleading. You actually get into them and you realize, oh, this map is nowhere as good as the pictures were. So I'll be looking into that. Who knows? Maybe we just do maybe that's when I do my big dairy farm thing, is on the dedicated. That would certainly appease all the people who want to do silage all the time. Amazing how much time it takes to harvest these fields. I was thinking, well, we probably knock out this little small field here on 4 and then get over there and do field 2, but it looks like time wise this one's going to take up the whole episode and then some. I mean, I'll look at the time. And we're already up to about 50 minutes on this. Or are we? Actually, no, we're not. Gotta remember there's 6 minutes of pre-roll on this video that I'm recording. I got ready to record this and then had an issue. And instead of stopping and restarting everything all over again, I just stopped it to let it roll. I forgot I have to cut off like the first 6 minutes of this video. So we're only around 42 minutes. Sometimes I forget about that stuff. Man, that thing's dirty. And we just washed it. Y'all are like, how come you never wash your tractors? Because I wash them and they're immediately dirty again. Alright, so 69-70%. I'll make this turn and call him, let him come over here and empty us. And that might get him full enough so he can go unload. Make our turn. There we go. Let's go ahead and start the driver back up and get him to come on over. Keep an ear out and an eye out in the mirror. There he comes. Right. Good stuff, getting all that canola in there. It's got him 88%, 90%, 96, 97. Okay, 98. Yeah, he'll be good to go. Nice. Let him go do his thing. All right, buddy. Go dump your load. All right, off he goes back to the farm. Get his thing done. All right. Good to go. What else is going on? That's about it. Not a whole lot happening right now. I'll probably start doing some cultivation in real life. Probably next week. I'm starting to see a little bit of green, but not much. But we'll probably get into that stage where it's time to do a little weed control here pretty soon. Oh, come on now. But yeah, it's getting that way. Getting about time to bring out the little cultivators and start running through the field. Chisel, chisel, chisel. But growth is looking good. We've had lots of good weather here. I mean, it rains a couple of days, and then we usually have 4 or 5 days of good sunlight. Rains a couple of days, 4 or 5 days of good sunlight, which is good. I mean, that's really what you want, you know. That way you're getting plenty of moisture into the field. You're not getting too much moisture into the field. And then you're giving the plant time to put it all to good use and grow. As long as that cycle continues, I'm a happy camper. We haven't had any real torrential downpours. So, we're in good shape. Great demand at Churchfield Farms for corn. That's good news, because we got a lot of corn we harvested that last couple of days. We should be able to take advantage of that. Should be able to make good advantage of that. Look at the inventory. Yeah, 170,000 liters of corn. We'll be able to make some money on that. Which is good, because we're sitting at 41,000 right now. So we definitely could use the influx of cash. Could use the money. Alright, dude is done emptying. Means he should be back on his way. Let's spin around and see if we see him coming down out of the trees there. Not yet. Just fine. We're only 17%. I just sort of like watching it happen. Kind of neat when you just see the tractor come on down here and do its thing. That's the cool part about course play. Being able to see it, have it look like it's multiplayer, but it's really not. There he comes. Oops, missed a couple little spots. We can get that though later on. So I guess we'll finish up this field, get this canola done, and with it done, then we'll be able to wrap up this video, and then we'll come back in our next video. We'll take advantage of that great demand for corn. Haul a few loads of corn off, and Man, that thing is just skating right there. There are some terrain issues for sure with this field. Come on, back up. Thought I lifted that head. Alright, drop that header down. Yep, get that cut done. So yeah, next time we're here, we'll get the great demand done. We'll start the harvest on field 2. And as soon as field 2 is done and we've got all the fruit out of the fields, we'll put the soul mod back in and we'll resume operations with it. And again, for those who are wondering why I took it out, I just wanted to get back into doing the farming, get some videos done, and get the harvest done without every other video being spraying. It's just so much spraying with the soul mod, and it sort of gets tiresome. Or at least I feel like I'm just wearing you guys out when that's all I'm doing all the time is spray, spray, spray. And, you know, I don't want you guys to get tired of it, but I know at the same time there's a lot of you guys who watch the videos to see exactly what's involved with Soul Mod and what needs to be, how you calculate and all that other stuff. So in one side of me, I want to do a whole everything straightforward day by day, do the Soul Mod, do all the spray in, do all of that. But at the same time, I know it probably gets old going, oh, what's on the agenda today for Mr. Moose? Spray the field. I don't know, maybe I can get a little bit better at getting the field pretty moist in the beginning and then coming back and only having to put moisture on the field once or twice, you know? I have learned a few other things. The fact that I can put herbicide down in the beginning at the same time as I put down fertilizer, that's gonna save one spray day right there, because you can go ahead and on one day do both your fertilizing and your herbicide, and so that the next day in the cycle you don't necessarily have to spray. Because there for a while it seemed like that was it. I would plant, the next day spray, water and herbicide, the next day I'd come back and have to spray water again, the next day come back, spray water, maybe some fertilizer, and then it would be harvest time finally. But yeah, when you're just spray, 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 I just don't know how well that translate for you guys on your end. I don't, let me know in the comments what y'all like. And maybe it's one of those things where I do some of the spraying off camera, don't record that, and just basically say, okay, well, in the last episode, this is what I did, or, you know, while we were away, this is what I did to get to this point. I sprayed this field, and I sprayed this field, and, you know, everybody got water. Or do you want me to go through and do each of the days of spraying for you, so that you can see what the numbers were and how the calculations go and how decisions were made? Oop, we run into a hedgerow somewhere. I don't even know where he's at. I guess these hedges aren't collidable, maybe? And that he's driven through and is in the pig farm? That's all I can figure. Still got some bales over there also that need to be moved over to the dairy farm. That hasn't been taken care of. Got to get that done. There's quite a bit of work to do on this farm. We'll get that taken care of soon. Alright. Get this last little piece cleaned up. And then we will shut her down. Let's tab over to him. See if we can get him out of the trees here. He's over there hiding, I guess. Alrighty. And we'll have to do the big move. Over to field 2 as well. It'll involve a header trailer because we just cannot drive these roads with this header on here. So what am I looking for? I'm looking for the period. That's it. Sitting here having a moment where I'm like, how come it's not unloading? Oh yeah, I'm in the class. Now I've got to hit the period. All right. I think it's that unloaded. Nice. So, yeah, we need. Let's drop this for now. And we'll go ahead and start her up. And I need to turn the IC on so I can actually get into this thing. Open up the door. There we go. Alright, so we'll run over here real quick. And we will grab the header trailer, take it over there. Get the header off of that combine real quick. And then we'll be ready to take everything over to field number 2 so we can finish up that harvest, which will be in our next episode. But again, thanks guys for all your support. I appreciate it. I know I missed. It seems like every time I get ready to hit a milestone, something happens. Either my internet gets disconnected, or I get sick, or a computer shuts down, and for some reason or another, every time I get to a good milestone where I need to say hello to everybody and thank you and all that other stuff, it seems like something happens. But doesn't mean I don't appreciate it, and appreciate everybody's support. I know we hit 14,000 last week, which is awesome, and I appreciate it so much. Welcome to all the new subscribers, guys. I appreciate it. And like I said, we'll start the live streams back up tonight, as this video is being recorded for Friday. So it's actually Thursday when I'm recording this, but it's going to be posted Friday morning. So yeah, we'll start the live streams back up tonight, and hope you guys can join me for it. And what will we be playing? Got no idea. There's a lot we can play. It probably won't be Farm Sim, because I do plan on playing some Farm Sim late night with Alex and Dan. So Let's back that up just a little bit here. All right, jump into the class. And we'll go ahead and fold that in. Shut down the operations here. Let's see if we can get this header on this trailer. It does not really fit this trailer either. I've yet to find a trailer these headers go on really easily. As you can see, it's just... It just doesn't work. And the other trailer that it really works on, I have the issue with it bouncing up and down, which is so frustrating because I love this... I like this combine, but I have the problem with now I don't have a header I can put it on. There. The best I can do with it. And no, that's not the best I can do with it. Awesome. Well, guess I'm going back to the farm to pick that header up. Just for giggles, I'm going to go around here and see if you can break the game and do this. I may have to go get the front end loader and try to flip it back over. Yeah, you can't break the game and do it. So, you know what? Instead of doing that reset back to the farm, I think that's what I'll do. Is in the next episode, we'll hook the front end loader up on that vent. And we'll see if we can't flip that thing over and then get it on a header trailer. So, just to do something different. So, that's what we'll do in the next one. Is we'll see if we can't get that header flipped over and then we'll get it put on a trailer and we'll move over to field two and take advantage of our high demand and all that other stuff. So, but anyways, thanks for watching, guys. As always, I appreciate it. It's good to have you along, and I will see you in the next episode, if not the next live stream. Thanks for watching, guys and gals. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, I hope you consider giving it a like, maybe even sharing it with your friends. It does help me out a tremendous amount and is greatly appreciated. Also, leave some comments down below. That's really the only way I can gauge if you guys are enjoying what's being put out. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want daily notifications. I try to do a new video each and every day. Also, if you want to stay in touch with me and find out what's going on, our social links are down in the bottom left-hand corner. Twitter is where I usually announce schedule changes, live streams, and new video releases. Facebook's a great way to get in touch with me if you have any questions to ask. And of course, I am trying to get to 1,000 followers on Google+, which I know I'll probably be old and gray before that happens. But if you can jump over there and follow me, it would be super awesome. So if you like today's video, there's a whole lot more content on the channel. I hope you'll browse through it, find something to keep yourself entertained until the next video or live stream. Speaking of live streams, I try to do them nightly around 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. Until the next time, thanks again for watching. See you soon.